Hello there and welcome back. In this video we are going to reinvent the wheel. So basically both Windows and Linux systems provide you with the log rotation facility. But I thought to myself, why should I not create a script that I can schedule to log rotate? And this log rotate is maybe a little bit misleading because it's not the logs that we want to rotate, but the idea is that if we have files older than a specific amount of days, hours, minutes, and so on, we would like to just simply remove them. And that's what we are going to do. So I have created a rat folder, and here is where our script will be created. Let's call this retention.py. And for this to work, we need to import the pathlib module. I think it became available since like 3.4 version of Python or something like that, but don't take my word for it. So you need to be using a fresh version of Python, and we would like to import the arg parse module as well, and from the date time module we import the date time and the time delta. And let's jump right to it. So first we would like to have a CWD constant defined, and basically this is going to be the current working directory. This is going to serve a purpose to try to find the folder relative to our work directory, but it could be changed. So what we would like to do is to use the os.path.sep, which is the path separator, and use the join function on this. And we use the os.path.abs.path_file, and we would like to split based on the os.path.sep and take the last one. So how does it look like? Let me show you, because this is like really a long and complicated line. So now Python retention. As you can see, this gives us the current folder where the script lives. All right, now we have the current folder. We would like to have a folder where we would like to apply this logic. So let's call it output. And this is basically the os.path.sep.join.cwd and the output. Yeah. And let's print this one out as well. Now we expect files to be produced inside this folder. And the beauty of this is that it is supposed to work on both Linux and Windows systems, because we are not hard coding any backslashes or forward slashes. We are just simply using Python's capability to run on different platforms. All right, did I start recording? Yes, I did. Okay, now what we would like to do is to create a, I don't know, timestamp or something like that for the file, so we can verify the functionality. It may not be necessary. Oh, let's skip it. So what we would like to do is to create our parser, which comes from the argparse argument parser, and basically we provide a description, and this script reinvents the wheel. Hopefully this is visible. Okay, now what we would like to do is to add a single argument. So parser add argument, and we would like to call it retention time with single and double dashes. And the type should be an integer. And the default is 7. And what we would like to do is to create the help text. So this argument specifies the amount of days up to which a file should not be deleted. And that's almost it. So arg is parser that parse args. And what we would like to do is to create the oldest possible date, which should come from the date time now, minus time delta. Args retention time times 1440. So basically this is how many minutes you have in a day. And basically we want to consider currently days, and that's why we like multiply this one. And yeah, so let's start the execution. And we say that the retention policy is args retention time days. Ah, bless me. Now what we would like to do is to check whether the output folder is something that we can count on. So checking if output is present. If output os.path that is there output, and if this is not the case, then what we would like to do is that the path is unavailable, aborting, abandon ship, raise system, exit. Otherwise, we don't need the else branch, so we continue with the execution. And let's call them all these. So all these, or old files, are basically the output of the os.listdir function on the output folder. And if we have old files, so an empty list is a false in Boolean, and a list with at least one element is true. So if we have files, which makes it true, then we should continue the execution. Otherwise, we could say that the specified folder is empty. Now, what we would like to do is to give it a test run. So, Python retention. Starting execution, retention policy is 7 days because we didn't specify any argument and the default came to be. Checking the path is unavailable and aborting. So, let's create the output folder. Now we run into the folder is empty, and just to show you, so retention time 3 days, it seems to be working as well. Okay, now how do we check the age of these files? So basically what we need to do and enter the picture, the pathlib module that we have just imported. So basically what we would like to do is to just let the user know that there are len output file the in the folder checking their age. So now what we need to do is to iterate over each file in old files and get the file name, which is going to come from the os.path.sep join output file, and then we need the fname, which is going to come from the pathlib.path file name. And now we can use the mTime, which is basically going to show us the last time the file was used or written to. You could change this to the creation time or whatever the criteria is that you have. And basically from time stamp is the function that we would like to use, and fname stat dot st mTime. And what we would like to check is whether the oldest possible date is greater than the mTime. If it is, then what we can do is to say that the file has expired and call the os.remove on the file name. Otherwise, we can say that the file is yet to expire, keeping it. Alright, now if we execute it, nothing will happen because there are no files. So notepad output test.txt. Let's just write something into it. And now we should have a different output. I seem to have some error here. Yeah, now we are keeping it. So if you are on a Windows platform, what you can do is to use the get item path output test txt and then use the last write time and this shows you when it was last accessed. And now what we would like to do is to add from the get date. I said get date, add days minus 5. What? All right, now what you will see is that come on. It's not minus but equals. Okay. Now it is the 25th of March, which is going to fall out of our retention time. And as you can see, Come on. Get item. Why do we have 36 files in the folder? Oh, come on. Okay. That was just a semantic error. That one files in the folder. Their output. Format list star. Last write time, creation time. Let's add it to the creation time. Print the file was file name split os path sep minus one was created on stir m time. Let's see. Okay. And now we will have the oldest possible date. Print the files created before string oldest possible date will be removed. Yeah. The file was created on this. Why is that? Something is fishy. Oh, minutes, that's what was missing. And voila, now it is working. So basically this is how you can create a script which implements this like policy. So as you can see, the files created before this date will be removed. We have one file which had its age adjusted, and then the file has been removed. Right. So basically this is how I reinvented the wheel. See you in the next one.